of the verdict. But I think one thing is pretty clear for anybody who watched this case closely. I don't know how closely you watched it, Drew or Jeremy. I know, Matt, you watched it really closely. For people who watched this case closely, there are elements here that it's very difficult to make the case to me that any rational jury would have who just looked at the evidence would have come to the conclusion that beyond a reasonable doubt, Chauvin was guilty of second or third degree murder. This just did not fulfill the elements. The third degree murder charge particularly is absurd on its face. The third degree murder charge never should have been allowed in the courtroom. The third degree murder charge is a charge for what is generally called depraved heart murder. Depraved heart murder is you throw a brick onto a freeway and you don't have anybody you're explicitly attempting to kill, but you end up killing somebody on the freeway. You shoot a gun into a crowd. That's depraved heart murder. And that was what the third degree murder charge was. You have to have intent to kill others, right? And then you end up killing one person. Mm. It was counted anyway. It shouldn't have been on the docket. The second degree murder charge required felony assault that results in the murder. So usually that is where you're robbing a store, you got a gun, the gun accidentally goes off and kills somebody, right? Or the guy dies for some other reason while you're in the process of committing some sort of felony. So you had to show that he intended to commit a felony against George Floyd. It's very difficult to say that he intended to commit a felony against George Floyd because Minneapolis Police Department procedure allows you to do exactly what Chauvin was doing under the circumstances. The manslaughter one was a little bit easier to make because the charges in the manslaughter case, you just have to have reckless disregard. So the prosecution can make the case that even if he didn't mean to do anything bad, it was reckless for him not to get off of Floyd. Once Floyd was already unconscious and once Floyd was dying, he should have gotten off of him and it was reckless not to get off of him. But the fact that they convicted on all three counts says to me that they weren't really looking at the evidence because, again, all three of those charges also rely on a simple question of causation, right? Did George Floyd actually die because Derek Chauvin was on top of him with his knee? What the defense showed repeatedly is that he did not have his knee on his neck, right? There was no physical trauma to his trachea. There was no evidence that there had been physical trauma to his arteries that would have cut off the oxygen to the brain. There are a couple of different types of asphyxia. There's physical asphyxia where you actually strangle somebody. There's you deprive somebody of oxygen to the brain by cutting off their blood supply via their arterial blood flow. And then there is a chemical asphyxia, which is drug overdose. And the fact is that George Floyd had three times the deadly level of fentanyl in his system. He was high as a kite. He had 75% arterial blockage. The medical examiner originally said if I'd found him dead in his room, I would have immediately assumed that it was a drug overdose. Right. And the only reason that this became a national issue is because of the tape, which on its face, when everybody first saw it, looks really ugly because it turns out that a lot of policing looks really ugly. And then when you get all of the lead up, at the very least, you don't have to say that you love what Chauvin did. You don't have to say that Chauvin acted appropriately. You don't have to say any of that stuff. What you do have to say is to not even believe that there's reasonable doubt on the murder charges where you'd have to have intent. That suggests to me that this was far less about the actual facts of the case and far more about all of the hubbub surrounding the case. This trial never should have taken place in Minneapolis. It should have immediately been transferred in terms of venue. You were not going to find an impartial jury in Minneapolis in the single most publicized criminal justice case of our lifetime, at least since Rodney King.